London on a rainy afternoon. We're at the British Museum, and depending on which class you're in, you're going to see either the Elgin Marbles or the Sutton Hoo exhibit.
In the early 19th century, many wealthy British aristocrats were interested in archaeology, among them Lord Elgin of Scotland, who had been appointed ambassador to Istanbul. While there, he managed to acquire the marble sculptures that made up the frieze work on the Parthenon, the ancient Greek temple to Athena. Today, almost all countries have laws that prohibit exporting antiquities. Artifacts must remain in and belong to the country of origin. But Lord Elgin dismantled all of these ancient carvings and had them shipped back to Britain. The ship transporting them sank, and these treasures had to be rescued from the bottom of the ocean, which pretty well bankrupted Lord Elgin. Eventually, he sold the marbles to the British government. Today, periodically, the Greek government tries to convince Britain that they should return this important part of their heritage. The British answer that the marbles would have been destroyed had Elgin not saved them. The poet John Keats came to see the Elgin marbles when they were displayed in the British Museum in 1816. Impressed with the marbles' antiquity, Keats writes about the marbles' ancient, weathered by time and nature, but still beautiful. In the famous first quatrain of his sonnet on seeing the Elgin marbles, Keats writes about his awareness of death. My spirit is too weak. Mortality weighs heavily on me like unwilling sleep, and each imagined pinnacle and steep of godlike hardship tells me I must die.
The poet John Keats lived in this white house that's behind me. In the house next door lived Fanny Braun, the girl that he loved and never got to marry. Here in the front yard of this white house, near the front door, grew a plum tree, and it was under this plum tree that Keats wrote one of his most famous poems, To a Nightingale. He wrote several other poems while he lived in this house as well. The house is closed for remodeling and refurbishing right now and will open again as a Keats Museum soon. When Keats learned that he was ill with what we now know was tuberculosis, he thought if he moved to Rome, the warm, dry climate might improve his health, and so he left this house to move to Rome. Unfortunately, he died there within a few months.